Somebody needed that this morning. So many times we allow our minds us from all this stuff. But I come this morning to tell you that you are free in Jesus. And whom the Son has set free, oh God, is free indeed. But you gotta be delivered from yourself. Because a lot of times God has already delivered. But we hold ourselves in bondage because we keep going back. Oh my God. Somebody ought to give him glory right there. Somebody needed that this morning. Somebody needed that. Because your past ain't got nothing to do with your present and your future. It's another step. God help us. That you have to endure. Jesus. We have another service today, so we're going to move. Amen. I thank God for another opportunity to be in the house of God. I thank him for life, health, and strength. I thank God for everything that he's doing in the mind of the people of God. I thank him for everything that he's doing in the kingdom of God. Lord, have mercy. Give God praise, glory, and honor for our awesome leaders. Amen. Bishop Harry Brown. Hallelujah. Our daddy, Bishop John W. Hanks. Our mother, Governor Linda Hanks. Give God some glory for their lives. My God, God is good. Come and tell somebody this morning, God will deliver. I don't know about you, but I done been through some things, and I know that God will deliver. And he's not a second chance God, a third chance God. I got a God that has more than enough chances because he already knew I would get in some stuff. But how many of you know that God will deliver? Woo! Hey, my God.
Yeah.
Y'all better say it. Yeah. See, when you done had an encounter with God, you can yell out at any point. I remember the old church. They didn't wait for a pump and a prime. I remember the old church. Somebody would be over there and they'll just think back on how good God is and they'll just take off running in the church. They'll just begin to shout, oh! Somebody will shout out, glory! Somebody will begin to shout, hallelujah! When they look at it and think back, God help me. So I give God praise that God will deliver. Even when it looks like and everybody done tried to intervene, God will deliver. Because sometimes God will let man do everything they can for you. But when it is an appointment for God, Lord have mercy, there is nobody you can go to. I don't care how much money they have. For some reason, they won't have it when you need it. I don't care if you got the best doctors going on. Take them up there to Moffitt. But if it's an appointment for God, good God have mercy, they can do everything that they can. But there will be nothing. Because when it is for God to get the glory, because we have to understand that our extremity is God's opportunity. Lord, have mercy. See, you haven't had an encounter with God until you're at a place where it feels like, God, I just want to give up. God, there's no hope. I have nobody. There is nothing. My bank account is empty. They're looking for me to pay them. They're calling me about my car. My mortgage is behind. The job is threatening to let people go. fifth chapter. Because when we understand that God will take us and have us in such a place that it looks like there's no hope. Mark the fifth chapter. My God. Y'all already there. Understanding the text, Jesus and the disciples came over to this country. And verse 2, he says, and when he was come out of the ship, immediately there met him out of the tombs.
Come on, Holy Ghost.
A tomb. A man with an unclean spirit. You ought to understand that a tomb is a cold place. Understand that a tomb is where they put people when they say there's no hope for them. That's where they put people when they declare them to be dead. Oh, have mercy. A tomb is a place that you don't see anybody that's got life to. So in other words, the situation looks very dead. But I come to tell you, don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. Even though it looks like it's dead, if I can recall at this moment, there was a man named Lazarus. He was a good friend of Jesus. And even though Lazarus had been dead for 4 days, the sisters had already talked about Jesus. They told him, if you had been here, Lord have mercy, how many people would be honest this morning and say, God, if you had been here, my child wouldn't have died. If you had been here, I would have kept my house. If you had been here, my children wouldn't be in the state that they're in. But I come to tell you, that God will deliver. And while it seems like they're in a tomb in their life, it is not the end for them. Because the God that I serve said that my seed is blessed. And if it looks like they have to have a tomb experience, that's because God needs to get the glory out of their life. Not by my works, but by his works will he deliver my children. Verse 3 says, who had his dwelling among the tombs. And no man could bind him, no, not with chains. In other words, he was out of control. There was nothing that could hold him. There's nothing that man created that would be able to contain this man. Lord have mercy. Because that he had been often bound with fetters and chains. And the chains had been plucked asunder by him. In other words, he broke the chains. And the fetters broken in pieces. Neither could any man tame him. I come to tell you this morning, God will deliver. You ought to look over and tell somebody, God will deliver. And so the text goes on to tell us that it was by day and by night that this man dwelled in the mountains and in the tombs. And this man was crying. And not only was he crying and locked up with chains, but this man was also cutting himself with the stones that was in the tomb. In other words, it sounds like to me that this man decided my life is not worth living. But I don't know about you, but when life begins to get so heavy, when things begin to go awry in life, when it feels like I'm all alone and nobody knows or cares about what's going on, if I can be honest, there are times when you feel like you just want to go to cutting on yourself. You want to go cutting your life off. You want to cut your communication off. You want to cut everybody off because you feel like there's no more good to my life. So he says, when this man saw Jesus, he didn't even see him close up. In other words, this man had, even in his situation, I believe this is telling us that this man still had an expectation. Why would he be looking for Jesus afar off if he did not expect that there would be church. I'm just coming to church. Gotta be there. If I don't show up, they're gonna think I backslid. They're gonna think something wrong. But the Bible tells me here, he says, he was looking and saw Jesus afar off.
Yeah.
All right. Amen.
And it says that when he saw him, he ran.
Yeah.
Amen. How many come in the house of God running? Yeah. Been running for Jesus a long time. Yeah. I'm not tired yet. Yeah. But are you running Jesus towards him? And then it says, I like this part, he worshiped him.
Yeah.
Just come in running and worship him.
Yeah.
They won't understand your worship, but just worship him.
Yes.
What is going on with him, but just worship him. Just begin to lift your hands and worship him. Anybody can give God praise.
Yeah.
But it takes something special to be able to worship God. Gotta be able to get prostrate on the floor and begin to tell him who he is in worship. You're not asking for anything.
Come on now.
In worship, you're telling God who he is. You're thanking him for what he's done. You're appreciating him. You're loving on him. This man began to worship him, even in his condition. In spite of living in the tomb, feel like I lost my mind. They said I'm crazy. They said I'm no good for nothing. They threw me out and told me, stay away, put me in a dark place. But even in my dark place, I began to tell him, God, you are. Let me drop this. Your eyes could be deceiving you. And he worshiped him. Says he cried with a loud voice and said, what have I to do with thee, Jesus? In other words, I'm so disconnected from you. Haven't I always done what I'm supposed to do? You told me to go left, and I went right. You told me to stand still, and I kept moving. You told me to close my mouth and stand and see the salvation. But I had to get my point across. In other words, sometimes, even when you feel like you need to justify, you need to clarify, you need to prove a point, you got to be able to say, God, you said, if I stand still and let you fight my battle, God have mercy, we will see the salvation of the Lord. You will do the delivery. This battle is not mine. Thou son of the Most High God, I adjure thee by God that thou torment me not. For he said unto him, come out of the man. Tell him God will deliver. We may not think he know when, but if I understand the process of purpose, God have mercy, I'll be able to endure the procedure. Lord, if I understand the process of purpose, I'll be able to endure my procedure. And what this man was going through was the procedure of God. And he had to endure it for a season. But the God that I serve, that is only but for a season. But my God said he will deliver out of it all.
That's his word, yes, ma'am.
And all he said was, come out of them, man. Come out of the man. Thou unclean spirit. So whatever you may be struggling with, Lord have mercy.
Well,
I know y'all, Look, I'm gonna say y'all in here ain't struggling with anything.
Well,
you know, you done made it in the ride.
Well,
but for those of us that are still struggling with some stuff, those of us that know that our mind be playing tricks on, those of us that know that we have some thoughts outside of the church walls that may not be like God, come on, those of us that open our mouths sometimes when we should be quiet, those of us that know that there are some things about us that we just have to wait on the prayer procedure and process of God, but until God deliver, can I learn how to sit down? Can I learn how to only give him worship? Can I learn how to call on the name of Jesus? Can I learn how to be quiet and let God fight my battle? Can I learn to wait to hear the voice of God? Is there anybody here that said, I deal with some stuff on a daily basis and it ain't always clean? I don't know about you, but some people need to know that everybody called ain't always clean.
What you say?
Sometimes God got to build an audience. He got to let some people know who he is. See, we have to understand that this thing is not about us, but it's about Jesus. And when he needs to get his point across, when he needs to convince some people, when he needs to persuade them of who he is and the miracles he's capable of performing, he may have to use you to be the one that the people will be able to see. Talking about you.
All right, come on. Come on now.
Wow, they see you struggling.
Yeah, that part. Come on.
Jesus. When they see you saying, can your car pick me up? Yeah. When you feel like you're blinded and can't see. Yeah. When you feel like my children are never going to get it together. Yeah. My children always. Yeah. My marriage is messing up. Yeah. And I'm not trying to be a statistic, but what I learned about God, if he meant for you to be that, then that's what it'll be. And so we have to understand, he says, thou unclean spirit. And he asked him, what is thy name? And he answered, saying, my name is Legion, for we are many. Many are the afflictions of the righteous.
Yes. Yes.
Y'all ought to have been shouting right there. Yes. Because I don't know if you somebody that have no afflictions, I need you to let me see you. Because I need to know what you're doing. Because something I'm doing is not right. Because I tell you, the afflictions are many. Whether they be mental, whether they be emotional, whether they be physical, whether they be medical, whether they be ministry, whether they be children, whether they be husband, whether they be wife. Many are the afflictions. And they know who to send to mess with you.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
They know what you're dealing with.
Yes.
They know what you struggled with. Yes. And now you want to say you say. Yes. You want to say you running for God. Yes. You on fire. Fire shut up in your bones. Yes. Uh-huh. Yes. Running for Jesus. And you ain't tired. Yes. You think them legions ain't going to come wear you out?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
That's their job. They're fulfilling their assignment in your life.
Jesus. Thank you.
Says, but even the legions have sense enough to know who Jesus is.
Yes, they do.
The legions said, we know you can just kill us.
That's right.
And if they know who he is, my God.
Well, we know.
If they know and have sense enough to say, wait a minute, the Job. But you got a hedge around.
That's right.
How did the enemy know there was a hedge around Job? If he never tried Job before. That love change our perception of our situation. Because when I can understand that my procedure that leads me to my promise, when I can understand they may throw me in a pit, they may even put me in a tomb, they might even try to sell me off and say, why don't y'all call her over there? Why don't y'all call him over there? See, I don't know about you, but I believe I can identify with Joseph, because that was a Joseph had to understand that the ones closest to him, good God, I don't know who that's for, but there's someone that's closest to you. But guess what? Them ones closest to you, they want to put you in a pit. They try to sell you. They trying to send you to the other side. When I come to tell somebody, be like Joseph and go through the process, because there's a learning in your pit. There's a learning in going to the other side, because on the other side, they'll appreciate what I have to offer. On the other side, I can tell them something and they'll receive it, because Joseph began to interpret the dreams. And when he interpreted the dreams, it gave him favor with the king. I don't know about you, but keep going through it. Understand that favor makes you look even better. Favor for me, it is fair. I don't know about you, but I'm gonna stop saying that favor ain't fair, because favor, it is fair to me. You take it like you want, but my favor, it is real fair. It gives me what God already promised. If I can just hold on and I can hold out, I know that God will give me a favor with the king, and I'll be sitting at the king's table. I believe he told me he'll make some things my foot stew. So why are you worrying about it? He already got me propped up. He already done brought me out. I believe somebody needs to understand that God will.
He will deliver.
Then you want a blessing like he'll deliver. You want a blessing like he'll deliver. Blessing like he'll deliver. Give him glory like he'll deliver. Give him glory, like he's gonna deliver, like he's gonna deliver. Man, I don't believe God. I believe he'll deliver. I believe he's opening doors. I believe he's making ways. Believe he's breaking them up. Believe he's breaking them out. You ought to give God glory. And we're closing.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. That's it right there. Somebody say, I got it. I got it. I got it. That's why I'm shouting. I got it. I got it. That's why I'm giving him glory. Because I got it. I got it. I got it. I don't know about you, but somebody got it this morning. Somebody got it this morning. I can go on a little while longer. Somebody got it this morning. I can still lift up my hands. I came in heavy, but I feel like he done lifted something up off of me. Even that are weary and heavy laden, he said, give it up to me. I'll give you some rest. Anybody give that this morning? God gonna deliver. Just hold on to the bloodstained banner. If you promised it, he's not a God that he will lie. Neither the Son of Man that he shall repent. Give God glory. Give God glory. Give God glory. Give him glory. Word says how be it Jesus suffered for not. But said unto him, go home to thy friends and tell them how great things the Lord had done for thee and had compassion on thee. Tell limb that the weapon may form, but it will not prosper. The God that I serve told me to come show you. He told me to come show you what great and marvelous works he's done. And while they told me I would never be able to wear these heels, I come to show you what great and marvelous works he's done. When they said I'd never be able to lift up my hands and overexert myself, I come to show you what glorious and marvelous works he's done. I come to tell somebody that if he did it for me, he'll do it for you. Do what the word says. Go and tell somebody. Tell them to tell somebody to tell somebody that he's done great and marvelous works. He's delivered me. 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 Lord, deliver me. God, high God. Somebody go home with that in your spirit. When you get in your house, all you say is, Lord, deliver me. Oh, God, have mercy. Stand to your feet all over this earth.
Yes, Lord, yes.
Begin to tell God.
Thank you.
Woo. Cause all I seem to do is hurt me.
Glory, 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 glory.
Somebody's hurting this morning. Stand to your feet. Begin to lift your hands.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And just begin to tell them what you need. God, you're no respected person. I don't want to tell anybody what I'm going through, but he said, just tell me. Yes, I see, but I need you to open your mouth and talk to me. Says he worshiped God. Talk to him. Begin to tell him. God, I know I dress it up and smile it up and make it look good, but God, I need you to deliver me. My God, can we just be real with the church? You're bleeding all over the place. You're hurting for real. And everybody sees you got a mask on. But can you just lift your hands and be real with God? I'm the one that want to cut myself, God. I'm the one that want to take the pills, God. I'm the one that want to just shut up in the dark and don't answer my phone and don't talk to anybody and don't show up and don't care if they call. Don't care if they do call. I'm the one, God, that I get home and I can't come out my room, God. Need you to be real with them right there. Right there, come on. Yes, this is your moment. This is your moment. He didn't go to man, he went to God. God, my mind, my mind, my mind, God, my mind, my mind, my mind, my mind, God. I know you said renew your mind daily, but God, there's some legions that's got my mind, God. My mind, my mind. But you may say, I understand what you're saying. The one thing about us in church, we gotta learn how to be transparent. You're good, stay right there. Because when people don't believe that you've been through anything, they wanna know how you can tell them about how good God is. Because I felt like at one point I was in a tomb, Lord have mercy. And nobody cared about me being my church. And while I was waiting for people to call me and see about me, and while I was waiting for my family to reach out to me, and while I was waiting for those that say they care about me to come call me, I want you to know, none of that happened. And you know what God said? Don't go to them. Don't worry about what they're doing. That's part of their assignment, not to call you. Somebody said, what you mean? That's part of the assignment. Because if God ever wants us to trust him, he's going to cut some stuff off that they can't even come see about you. It doesn't mean they don't love you. It doesn't mean they don't care about you. It could be a mama hate that you cross her mind and she begins to intercede because she don't know either. But God has said, I'm waiting on you to call my name. So that I can deliver you. Just lift your hands. You may want to come to the altar and we touch and agree, but everybody don't come to the altar. Lift your hands right away. I believe in the God that I serve. And I believe that he's omnipotent, omniscient, he's all of that. He's everywhere, anywhere, at all times. And I don't believe that you have to come to me. I need you to go to him. Don't come this way. I need you to go that way. And while you lift your hands, put that thing on your mind. And begin to say, God, deliver me. Deliver me from my mind, God. Deliver me from my emotions, God. Deliver me from this thing, God. Because while he may not deliver you from the situation, because your situation is a part of your process, but while you're in it, he'll deliver your mind so he can change how you see it. While you're in it, he'll deliver you being so emotionally attached